And today's story is called Alone in the Woods, written and illustrated by Ian Begg, and recorded with kind permission from Scholastic. It was a perfect spring day. Come on, said Lily, I want to go on a picnic and fly my kite. Let's ask Mum. Lily asked Mum if Ted could come, and of course he could. So they gathered up the picnic things and the kites and set off. Halfway up the steep hill, Lily asked, are we there yet? Not far, said Mum, we'll be there soon. At last they reached the top of Windy Hill. They chose the perfect spot. They laid out on the cloth, laid the cloth out for the picnic. Lily set Teddy down under a tree. Poor old Teddy, said Lily. There's none for you, but you don't need a picnic, do you? After the picnic, Mum said, let's fly a kite. Which one shall we take? Lily chose the yellow one. So Mum and Lily set off, leaving Teddy all alone to guard the picnic. Suddenly, a great gust of wind blew and tugged at the end of the red kite. The kite lifted up and, oh dear, tugged at Teddy. Teddy bumped along the ground. He was lifted over some prickly brambles and just missed a cowpack. As the kite lifted higher and higher, Teddy was dragged through a hedge backwards. He held onto the kite string with all his might because he was flying high up in the air. Now he was higher than the clouds. He flew as high as an aeroplane. Whee! Waved Teddy. Higher and higher and higher still. This was so fun. And suddenly the wind dropped and the kite began to fall down through the clouds. And Teddy fell with it faster and faster, lower and lower, down, down into the woods until he landed plop into something green and sticky. He heard voices whispering in the bushes. When he looked up, Teddy saw bright eyes looking at him. He felt frightened. Teddy was alone in the woods. Then slowly out of the shadows, they stepped. First one, then two, the three, four, and then more, and more, and more teddy bears. You landed in our jelly, they said. Never mind, don't be shy, tuck in. It's a party. It's a teddy bear's picnic. They feasted on jelly and honey buns and lemonade, and they had all had a little sleep. When Teddy woke up, it was getting late. How will I get back, he said. Don't worry, said the bears, we'll help. And so they did. It took a little while to get Teddy into the air, but after all the jelly and the honey buns, but after one big heave, the wind lifted him above the trees, over the hills, far, far away, all the way back until he landed very gently with the softest bump just where he'd started. And when Lily and Mum came back, Lily said, what a good bear, you missed all the fun. Never mind, come on, time to go home. Good night, Lily. Kiss, kiss. And good night, Teddy. Sleep tight. But we know what really happened, don't we?